What we're trying to do in the laboratory is to simulate a process that we think was very common on the early Earth. And it's still common today, in fact. Whenever rain falls on a volcano, it makes little puddles that are heated by the volcanic energy. When it stops raining, those puddles evaporate. So we have a wet-dry cycle occurring all the time on volcanic areas of the present-day Earth. In the laboratory, we are simulating that by building a chamber. The chamber has got to be anaerobic, meaning there can't be any air in it, because the oxygen in today's chamber and in today's atmosphere will damage the chemicals we're trying to work with. So we are loading this chamber up with an inert gas. It happens to be carbon dioxide, but we could use something like nitrogen if we wanted to. Carbon dioxide is easy to use. We have a tank sort of blowing CO2 into the chamber. And as the CO2 comes into contact with the reaction medium that we are testing, it dries it out. We have the equivalent of volcanic heat. We have two heaters under a big disc, an aluminum disc that is turning very slowly. And every vial that is embedded in this disc, and there's 24 of them, goes through one wet-dry cycle every 90 minutes. So that's how we're simulating it. We're drying it out under a stream of carbon dioxide. We're rehydrating with just plain old water. Then it goes through another drying cycle. This occurs every 90 minutes. And in a typical experiment, we'll have about 4 of these cycles in a day that we will then analyze the result and see what we've made, if anything.